you gain sweat stench for 1 year. A stench of sweat follows the character around for 1 year. So apparently I don't know how to go to take a bath, so I will be sweaty as hell and smell shit for 1 year. Welcome back to Crusader Kings 3. My name is Kroni and we are playing as Chief Mielus of Finland. In the last episode we managed to gain the Duchy of Finland for our names and it is now our primary title. We also hold the title High Chiefdom of Savo here, as you can see. And we also have one part of Karelia. And we are aiming for Viipuri, so we would have 2 parts of Karelia. And Viipuri, we cannot currently attack Mr. Chieftain Ahma, because we have a truce until year 881. So yes, that is our current situation, so maybe we are gonna go and aim for the Pohjanmaa Duchy next. And as you can see, the Duchy is not as big as the Pohjanmaa currently is. So maybe this will be our next goal. And if we look at the kingdom titles, it is part of the Kingdom of Finland. So pretty much Karelia and half of the current Pohjanmaa is what we are missing from Kingdom of Finland. And of course this small part, because Sweden, Kingdom of Sweden has took it here. The County of Finland and the County of Ahvenanmaa. So yes, this is our current situation, so let's start and continue from here. So let's unpause the game and check a few things while we see what is going to happen. In the house Hämäläinen, currently High Chieftain Mielus and his 5 High Chieftains Pieta. They have 3 daughters, Emmi is betrothed to Kettukarjalainen. It is the son of High Chieftain Ture of Karelia. Also, I have another daughter, Elizabeth, now much better looking and not a little gremlin like she was before. She is becoming a beautiful young lady. Also, I have Elina Hämäläinen, my newest daughter, 2 years old. Lalli also had his first daughter, Pihla Hämäläinen, and actually his 5 is currently pregnant and not again, so he will have 2 children soon. Good job, Lalli. You are making a pretty nice job in the baby department. You are 20 years old and 2 children already. Now let's hope for a son. Okay, we got an event. At first I thought a simple footman a fool for stepping onto the training field. However, the battle proved more hard-fought than I expected. And it gradually became clear that he would be unable to stop his wild and vicious strikes from hurting me. Disarming him suddenly became a matter of life and death. I tried not to show my relief when his sword finally hit the ground. I could use more people like you. Ihanti Suensari joins my court. We gain 30 opinion of him and he will gain 30 opinion of me. This peasant and my soldiers will get a lecture on honor. I will gain 150 prestige and 100 piety. I strike him down where he stands. Ihanti Suensari is killed by me and I gain 20 dread. So let's check this guy out. 10, 12, 13. Let's check my council. He is better chancellor than my son. He is not that good steward or marshal. Or spymaster or learning, so not good priest either. He has pretty high personal combat skill, so he would make a good champion. But I would also like this prestige bonus. Maybe. What is my current champion situation? Well, I'm missing a lot of champions, so welcome aboard, my friend. Welcome. Can I actually make the decision to invite champions. Not yet. I'm missing one prestige. I could work off some stress or attempt suicide. Huh. Maybe I try this one. Let's see what it says. Nothing eases the mind like raised bulls and healthy sweat. I will work my body until my mind is more at ease. You will lose some stress. You gain sweaty stench for 1 year. A stench of sweat follows the character around for 1 year. So apparently I don't know how to go to take a bath. So I will be sweaty as hell and smell shit for 1 year. Well, it gives general opinion minus 5. Why not? Why not? Let's do it! Stress coping, sweat it out. As I finish yet another lap around my castle, I can already feel my worries dripping off me. Together with the sweat, some people say I run from my problems, but I say I run toward solutions. I can do another lap and I can gain, well, the same stuff, and I lose 24 stress. So now my stress is 49 out of 300. Pretty nice. Yes, and let's check our realm. Where is my realm? Here. I have two vassals now. My marshal, my champion, my vassal, and my good friend, Chief Time Matti. He is the chief of Finland down here. But I'm getting penalty because I'm not his rightful liege. That means that I don't hold the duchy of Karelia. So in reality, Chieftain Ture is his rightful liege. So that's why I'm getting penalties. Like you can see here, I'm getting plus 40% contribution from Talvikki's vassa levies. But Matti only has 20% because I'm getting penalty x 0.5, not rightful lease. My spouse gained a skill of strategist. Nice. Well, currently I cannot do anything about this situation because I don't hold Karelia and I am allied with Karelia, so I'm not going to break that alliance. Another one is Siftas Talvikki. She hates me, and one big problem currently is that she wants a seat on the council. But she has such a sucky stats, so I'm not given her any positions yet. So we shall see what we're going to do about that. She is powerful vassal. And yes. Let's unpause. Do we have anything here? Few champions. Yeah. We know all of that. Now we have 5 out of 7, we have Matti, Chieftain Matti, we have Ihanti, Petri, Asek, Lalli. And we could invite Karle to join our court. He has pretty bad stats and pretty bad prowess, so no thank you. Yes. Let's see what we can do about this. We still don't have enough fame to make a duchy conquering war. We still need pretty much for that 1300 for the next fame level. So we could go for the county. He has 4200 soldiers. Oh, he has two alliances. And we currently have, well, we are not nearly, we don't have nearly enough soldiers for that fight yet. So maybe I should think about some alliances for now. I have still two daughters that are unmarried. So I could check out Estonia, King Nalka of Estonia. Hello, King Nalka. I have my son has an Estonian wife. You have a son, Vambola. You have a daughter and two other sons. Well, how old is he? He is betrothed already. Never mind, man. How about Raholäänemaa? Yes, Raholäänemaa. Would you want to think about my daughter Elizabeth? Yes, you would like to accept it. Because you desire an alliance. Elizabeth Hämäläinen gets 400 prestige and Rahor doesn't get anything because he is the higher rank here. Almost accepting the matrilineal marriage. Damn. Let's see if we can... 56 is a pretty high price to pay for that. There has been another war. Our neighbors High Chieftain Ture has won against Ahma Itkonen. Oh, so Karelia took the Viipuri. So Viipuri is no longer our target. Damn. Well, what were we doing? We were doing this one. Maybe we try to sway you. 52% chance to... chance. Let's do it. I would like to have the matrilineal marriage. Now let's check our house. We have 10 members, 7 living members. We have me as the househead, Lalli, Emmi, Metta, oh my, another granddaughter, Elizabeth and Elina. A lot of daughters in this family now. Here we cannot do anything yet. And here we can see our family tree. Pretty nice. We have 109 renown. And we are in need of about 300 more until the next level of splendor. And up here we can see actually that we are gaining... let's wait, it locks here. We gain 0.64 per month. We have 7 living members and 1 duke. So that is pretty nice. Let's keep going and let's try to sway and let's like to make a matrilineal marriage with Estonia, King of Estonia. A Caesar triumph. While studying the tactics of ancient generals, I was amused to learn about Julius Caesar's exploits during his conquest of Gaul. During his siege of Alesia, Caesar determined that his direct assaults on the well-fortified city would be too costly. He instead ordered his army build his own fortress, which surrounded the entire city, trapping the enemy garrison inside the star while simultaneously preventing reinforcements from relieving the defenders. A little ingenious goes a long way in a siege. We would gain trade military engineer, siege space time minus 30%. Make the enemy come to you. I like it. You would gain trade unyielding defender, friendly fatal casualties minus 25%. Caesar took a risk with that plan, but it paid off. You gain trade reckless and I gain 12 stress because I'm a diligent. And reckless would be minimum patrol minus 4 and maximum patrols plus 6. That would be nice. We could roll much higher. Or we could not... Warsaws aren't fall like these days and we would not gain anything. So do we want some siege time? Or some fatal? Maybe I go with these, yes. Let's try to get some nice barrels going on. A little bit rest. Luckily we just reduced our rest, so it's pretty okay. Elina Hämäläinen increased her intrigue by 1. And I have gained trait reckless. Now I am a reckless lunatic athletic. I am also Grey Eminence and a Reaver. And my personal combat skill is pretty low. And no can do. And I can choose another lifestyle perk. We could gain control in county progress gain plus 20%, or we would gain army maintenance minus 15%, friendly territory level reinforcement rate by plus 100%. Well, I am going with the control now. I have gained some land, so I need to make some controls, like Käkisalmi is only 14 out of 100. And Olavillina I'm currently increasing the control, so it is 59 out of 100. And here is 44 and 34 and 32 under my another vassal. Nyland I think has 100, Tavastian Sysmä has 100, yeah. We also have now a little bit income, so we could try to... where is my council? We could put our steward to increase development in county of Porvo. Because it's currently our capital, so it would be nice to get it up. It's only one at the moment. And it will increase all the boost in levies, taxes and supplies. Supply limit. So it's pretty important to get your development up as soon as possible. And if you need money, then you go and collect taxes. Well, let's put a lolly hämäläinen do some domestic affairs and let's try to increase our Talvikki's opinion of me. So damn Karelia. You took my Viipuri. Pohjanmaa has... Who is you allied? You are allied with Jarl Magnus of Drændalok and High Chieftain Baevi of Kuolladat. Kuolladat is there. And this another one is where? It's there in the Norway. Alright. So they are even pretty close, so they would be able to help him right away. How is Sweden doing? You are allied with a snake in the eye, Jarl Sigurd of Sjælland. And that is here in the Denmark. King Nalga is not swayed. You will make another attempt. Well, it was 50-50 chance. So no worries. Well, let's hope it will work out. Should I invite some champions? Or should I want to save my prestige? Let's do it. Let's hope we get some nice council members at the same time. I would like to get some better Chancellor and Spymaster at least. Maybe even Nuadi. But let's see what happens. Let's let the time pass and let's hope my champions arrive. My new champion. Here is the first one, Kaleva. 2.11.778 and 18 personal combat skill. He is a strong man. Right. Not that good. Pretty good. Pretty decent in the combat skill department, but otherwise a pretty bad stats. Well, let's see the other ones. Let's wait and see. How about raiding? Can we raid anywhere? Not my allies. How about here? 3, 3. Okay, you are fighting. You are fighting against High Chieftain Kiala of Orjedje in the Dirt Pohjanmaani conquest of Chiefdom of Julevadno. And you are currently losing by -12%. Pretty nice. Here is 3 coins. Estonia. What about here? 0, 0. Well, not very... Doesn't look very good for raiding right now. So we have to wait a bit. Is here someone who is raiding already? Perhaps. Did I get the other champions yet? I have Karle and Kaleva. An experienced fighter. He would make a good vassal, humble. Karle, 1, 10, 2, 3, 5, 9. Not very good. Alright. Let's see. Let's hope for someone better. We have still low county control, but we are fixing that. Well, this one is not so easily to fix because Talvik is such a bad character. Too few champions, we are trying to fix that and we can declare wars. And I have to designate a guardian for Elisabeth Hämäläinen. And I shall teach her myself. And a champion, Budak, has arrived. 18, 10, 6, 7, 9. This is what I wanted. He is a big man. He is a giant. Holy shit. He doesn't even fit in his portrait background. So let's invite him. Welcome, my friend, welcome. Welcome to Court of Mielos. And you will become my Chancellor. I'm sorry, my son, but you have to learn more until you can be any use to me. And Budak is now my Chancellor, and he is doing the domestic affairs. I noticed that my opinion is only minus 27 now with Talvikki, so it's going up. Oh, if we even give her the council position, she would be on positive side, plus 20. Well, only thing I could think of her would be as a Noadi. I lost 2 points, but I think it is worth it. Let's see. Yeah, I can put her as a spymaster, but not as a Noadi. Fine. Then she is no use to me in the council. Only plus 8 intrigue. No thank you. Due to impressive high shift and Mielos of... God damn it. Everything. I'm pause and everything is coming. I call you to honor our alliance and join me in the Karelia conquest of the chiefdom of Kitka. You do know that he has a pretty big army. How many do you have? Well, we are not nearly as much as him unless he lost his alliances. No. Well, let's go. Let's do it. Let's try to do some damage on him so it's easier to attack him. Quite satisfied. Emmy has been asking me for a ragdoll for a long time, and I told her I would get one for her in 3 months if she displayed more focus in her studies. She responded that she was fine with her current dedication to her studies, reward or no reward. We all learn to live with our lot in life. Emmy keeps the trade content. I should teach her a more flexible way of thinking. I gain 35 stress. She will lose trade content and gain Fickle. Fickle is diplomacy, stewardship, hostile scheme resistance. Okay. Emmy must be taught to take me at my word. I gain 35 stress and she will gain trust. Plus 2 diplomacy, minus 2 intrigue. Well, let her keep content and let's not get any more stress right now. And let's get the last champion for ourselves. Where is my card? Yeah. What was your personal comp? You are 18. You shall join me. Welcome, my friend. Welcome. Now I have full champions. Raise all my armies. Let's go. Let's join my friends here, so we have a bit better numbers advance. Okay, we have at least... Well, we have pretty nice numbers. Well, I'm helping Karelia grow, but I hope I can steal some of his land. He is coming here. And if I check, yeah, we don't need it. We don't really need it, we only need down here. Marshal earns respect. Chiefdom of Olavin gained Marshal guidance for 5 years. Well, it's my Matti. What else can you expect from him? He is the best Marshal ever. King Nalkas Wayed. Okay, let's check out that one. Estonia. 54 now. Rahon, arrange a marriage, and I shall give you Elizabeth. You will accept. I want the matrilineal marriage, and you will accept it. Let's send a proposal. Then our children will be Hämäläinen. House Hämäläinen. Or their children. A demonstration of leadership. My wife, High Chieftain Pieta, has been hovering around my council meetings lately. Knowing her interest in the matters of leadership, I cannot help but feel that the woman is waiting for me to impress her. I could properly engage her in a conversation. On the other hand, it might be better for her to simply see me interacting with my man. There is something to be said for at least pretending to know every soldier's face. Let us discuss methods of communication. We should go greet some recruits. You gain 50 martial lifestyle experience. Holding of Nyland get respected figurehead, that is Levy reinforcement trade plus 25%. Or I could gain same experience but plus 20 opinion. Well, I should go with this one of course. That is a big push, puff for our Levies. And now we are allied with King Nalka of Estonia. Due to Serene High Chieftain Mielos of Finland, I gladly accept your betrothal proposition. Your daughter Elizabeth will be betrothed to my son Raho. Signed by King Nalka of Estonia. Excellent, excellent. Now I have two allies. Let's go to Kitka. Why we are not going Kitka? There is no one here. Where is our enemies? What is here? Army will take attrition. No can do. Supply limit should be enough here. Yeah. Another champion, Valto, plus 15, 10-5. Well, you are shit as well, my friend, I'm sorry. Oh, there is a big... Can you come to my aid, my friend? Let's take Oulu for now. Wait until he gets here. And now we attack. We attack to Keta. They are defending in Taitsa. More army commanders face more men at arms counters, but we have better army commander. Mr. Maat... Oh, myself. I'm sorry, myself. And more soldiers. I think I am leading. No, it is Matti. Yeah. Running away, my friend. Well, don't worry. We reinforce, my friend. Go! Go, boys of Finland! Go, men of Finland! Attack! And we came here to steal the victory. And now we shall siege Kitka. So we will have the war goal. In our name. Oh, Estonia came to help. Bye! You run away, my friend. We shall take Kitka. And then we have to check out there is 1000 stack up there. Here are we taking, how much are we taking? Attrition 1% per month, not that bad. I cannot. We have 2606 soldiers yet. They have, well, that is neutral army. Where did they run away again? They are hiding. Are that my lands? No. Wait. The raiders in my kakisalmi, motherfuckers. Sons of bitches. Enemy ally Charbjörn has joined. Fine. They are getting even more troops and we want the siege at Kitka and we shall go now down here. They are running away. Yes, they are getting away. Rest for the weary. Sweaty, tired and in need of food. A long day of training with the troops is coming to an end. As we search for a place to camp, we spot an old and abandoned castle in the distance. Rearranging my shirt, I declare, that is where we will make our camp tonight. The sun is setting and with every step towards the ruin, it looks more ominous. Before long, the soldiers are whispering about the coast. Let us venture inside. I'm sure there's treasure to be found. Let us raise the tents outside, it's time to rest. My soldiers would gain heightened morale, but I think I go check if there is treasure. I am a greedy bastard. Searching for the unknown. Darkness, dampness and desolation reign inside the castle. And all traces of life are gone. Peering up decaying stairs, I spot what might be the remnants of lost tapestries and old paintings. Looking down spiraling steps, I see only darkness, reaching far down into the ground underneath the castle. We search the upper floors. There is 57% chance that we gain 75 gold, or 43% chance that we only get 15 gold. Or we could go deeper down. We would have 90% chance to get faced my fears for 10 years, Personal combat skill plus 1 and stress gain minus 10%. 10% chance to lose 20 dread and gain 46 stress. Well, I think I take the man. And we gained the better one. We gained 75 gold. Well, I think we are going to end the episode here. I think it's been long enough now, so check me out next time when we continue this war against Pohjanmaa. And thank you for watching. Remember to subscribe and like, and Crony out. Bye.